Good evening. This is Attorney Margarita, and you're with us for Partners in Law. Co-hosting with me this evening is Lieutenant Commander Jim Aris Alagao, Philippine Navy. He is the Chief of the Public Information Office of Central Command. Good evening.
Good evening, Attorney Marge, and to all our viewers. Magandang gabi din.
And I'm very to introduce to us this evening our guests. We have Colonel Samuel Gotico. He is the Staff for Operations U3 of Central Command. Good evening, sir.
Yes, good evening po to all the viewers. Good evening to everyone.
And also with us this evening is the Commander of Central Command. I believe you're the 16th Commander, sir, of Central Command.
Yes.
With us is Lieutenant General Nicanor M. Vivar.
Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat, sa mga ating tagapanood, at ako'y masaya at ako'y nasa inyong programa tonight.
And for this evening, we'll be discussing the different programs of Central Command and also their upcoming anniversary. So this coming December, this December 1 is the pang-ilang anniversary natin, sir, sa CENCOM po.
13th. This is actually our 13th birthday, our anniversary, 13th.
Because prior to CENCOM being called CENCOM, it was called VISCOM, I believe.
VISCOM, yes.
What year did we start calling it VISCOM? CENCOM po.
Maybe Jim can elaborate on this.
Actually, sir, on May 17, 1942, so this was first 3rd Military Area. The camp was then at Camp Guadalupe, which is now the Barangay Guadalupe. After which, it became a brigade separate in the 1970s. They were addressing the Muslim rebels. And then after which, lumipat tayo sa home natin ngayon, sa Camp Lapu-Lapu. And they made it Regional Unified Command. And then naging VISCOM. And then until December 1 of 2001, na-establish na yung Central Command.
What about that area previously occupied in Guadalupe? It's no longer occupied by AFP.
Right now, hindi na siya military area.
What are our activities for this upcoming anniversary? Or our pre-activities?
May I answer the question? We have, in fact, we have started our pre-anniversary activities, mass wedding, and we had 6 couples attended that activity. And we also have a MedCap activity last 31 October at Barangay Sinsin, Cebu. And we're able to give services to more than 1,000 residents thereat.
What services are these, sir?
Iba-iba po. May free haircut, may free legal advice, may feeding programs. Even dental services, we also provided that to the residents there. And we also started our sports fest as part of our pre-anniversary activities last November 11, and it will be concluded this coming Thursday. And let me also take this opportunity to announce to our media practitioners that we'll have a fun shoot with the media. So please come and join us. And on
who can they contact, sir, with regard to this?
Yeah, they could contact Jim. Okay. For that purpose.
Maybe and later we could flash his number so our media practitioners could contact him.
Yes, thank you for that. And of course, this coming November 30, we have a golf fellowship to be conducted at Mactan Island Golf Club. So for details, also Jim has that information to provide.
Okay. So we already discussed the pre-anniversary activities of CENCOM then. I'd like to ask, what's the area of responsibility of CENCOM, our armed forces in the Visayas?
Alam naman natin na ang Central Command caters the whole of Visayas. And this is actually Region 6, 7, and 8. So lahat na yung buong region na yun, tatlong region, ito ang sakop na pinag-iayaman ng Central Command.
So this covers Region 6, 7, and 8.
Yes.
So we have our Army, our Navy, our Air Force.
Yes, yes. Ang Central Command kasi it's actually a composite command na may lahat ng branch of service of the armed forces ito'y mayroong...
So, NAV4SEN is there po?
NAV4SEN, of course, is one of our units, but they are OPCOM to us. Not actually an organic unit sa amin, but they are on OPCOM status to us.
For purpose, for the pleasure of viewers, sir, ano yung OPCOM po?
OPCOM is actually, para na rin organic, kaya lang, mayroon silang sariling kampo, mayroon silang sariling base, na pagka mayroon kaming kailangan sa kanila, we can direct them. Mm-mm. Medyo mahabang explanation yung OPCOM, but practically it's the same as a unit under the
dito po sa CENTCOM, ano yung mga OPCOM units natin?
Ang meron po dito, itong OPCOM na NAV4 Central, tapos itong 53rd Engineering Brigade, at itong second RDP didibatihan pa kung ano talaga status nila. But definitely, yung TOG-6 and TOG-8 na under ng second RDP are OPCOM to Central Command. So, we give orders to them.
Ano yung TOG po?
For TOG, ito yung Tactical Operations Group ng Philippine Air Force. Mm-hmm. Sila yung naghahawak ng air operations ng mga lugar. Yung 6, nasa Iloilo to.
Region 6.
Region 6 ang hawak niya. Mm-hmm. Ibig sabihin, lahat ng air operation sa lahat ng Region 6 and part of Corps 7, sakop nila. And then yung Region 8, ito yung TOG-8, sa Leyte naman, Samar, ayan yung kinocover niya.
Since last year, ang dami po mga disasters from earthquakes to typhoon Haiyan po. So, yes. I'd like to ask, ano yung mga programs ng CENTCOM po for disaster preparedness?
Naku, madami po. In fact, pagdating ko dito, mayroon na silang mga programs. Ito yung aming ini-enhance para nang sa gayon ay sigurado, makasigurado tayo na prepared yung ating kasundaluhan at saka yung mga local government na handa sa anumang sakuna na sana huwag naman nakatulad ng Haiyan. So siguro si Sam can add to that.
Okay, yes. But idagdag ko lang po sa sinabi ni General Vivar kanina, yung tungkol sa OPCOM. OPCOM actually is operational control. Mm-hmm. And we have also units under OPCOM, operational command naman ng CENTCOM, which are the 3rd Infantry Division.
Which is located
in Hamindan na Capiz. Yes. Mm-hmm. And we have the 8th Infantry Division doon sa Samar naman siya located. So as far as yung disaster preparedness is concerned, yes, we have enhanced the existing program of CENTCOM nung dumating kami dito. And we have established a stronger link with other agencies of the government and even non-government organizations in such a way that in any case na may emergency, ang aming coordination ay mas mabilis, madali na lang makapag-provide not only the armed forces, not only the central command, but the whole of the government could easily provide services and assistance to the public.
Because we have seen that during the onset of Typhoon Haiyan na no one was really taking it, better controls could have taken place. I think you would agree with me. So, I think better exercises are being done now. Better cooperation,
we do.
Interoperability.
Yes.
And I believe last May, I think the Hawaii National Guards are here. They conducted urban search and rescue, if I'm not mistaken. Mm-hmm. So are there more activities like this to be conducted in CENTCOM?
Yes. We also have this communication exercise. Mm-hmm. We will do that in the near future, within this year, of course, that will test our communication capability of how we could immediately contact all other units participating in any kind of disaster. So, ang communication kasi is very vital. One of the lessons learned nung previous na, yun na nga yung Yolanda, talagang isa sa mga challenges ang communication. Mm-hmm. So, we have to do that also and exercise in such a way that we have a very good communication if magkakaroon ulit ng emergency. We have tabletop exercises, we have conferences, and we also have field training exercises to be conducted to further enhance our preparation for that.
What's the very recent exercise po natin?
We'll be first, other than regular coordination meetings with other government agencies, we in the armed forces, we in CENTCOM, the immediate is communication exercise. So we'll have a simulation, then we'll use our existing communication and backup communication to check if we are prepared, better prepared.
for that purpose.
Actually, we're doing this, we call it OREX, operational exercise. We are going to do that every now and then. In fact, last month, we did one. And we intend to have more this coming days. But of course, I assume that there are only 3 more typhoons coming in. I just don't know. But hopefully, wala nang malakas.
Hopefully, wala nang.
At saka hindi pinapanalangin natin na wala nang ganon. But definitely, we are doing our best to make sure na handa ang Central Command, pati na yung ating mga kasama sa local governments, kung sakali mga magkaroon ng problema. Hindi lang bagyo, pwedeng lindol, anything under the brackets of the calamities.
I believe GTF 7 or Joint Task Force 7
yes.
has a new commander. Leading
wala
GTF?
Pa.
Wala pa po.
Wala si General Labrador pa din, but he's retiring November 28th. So there will be another one coming in. They told me that it's Brigadier General Castro, who happens to be my classmate also. But he's coming in December pa. So that will be the time that there will be a change of command. I just don't know if that will be pushed through.
Yung JTF 7 po, this is not just for Cebu, but for Region 7.
No, no. Actually, JTF 7 covers... It covers actually the whole of Cebu, the Cebu Island, and Bohol. Dalawa yung hawak niya, Bohol at Cebu.
But JTF 7, its function, it's not only during times of disaster.
Ah, yes, hindi lang. We maintain also yung
security
dito.
What are the other functions of JTF 7?
Oh, marami.
Probably the one of the most important is immediate response during disasters and calamities and security requirements for Bohol and island of Cebu.
Since you mentioned security requirements, what's the border boundary? When does AFP come into place and when does PNP or GTF 7 come?
Sa security kasi, it's always, when we talk about security dito, ito ay, it's a magandang city. Usually, ang first responder talaga dyan is PNP. Support kami. But when it comes to internal security operation, kami yung lead agency, ang PNP ang support. So practically dito sa Cebu, PNP talagang nauna. But of course, since nandito kami and alam naman natin na ang ratio ng population sa police ay hindi din parehas at medyo kukunti sila, kami yung tumutulong. So malaking bagay na PNP at saka AFP yung magkasama. And other local.
In San Compo, how many men and women do we have in the armed force?
Naku, madami.
Madami.
I just don't know the reals ko, but the whole of Central Command, nasa 12,000 to 14,000. That is to include the 3rd Infantry Division, the 8th Infantry Division, the whole of the JTF 7, the headquarters CENCOM, NAB 4 Central, Engineering Brigade, and so on and so forth. Ang daming units dito.
Since we were talking about internal security a while ago, how's the peace and order situation in the Visayas? Well, ilang areas we consider na hindi red?
Actually, kukunti na lang. There are 16 provinces in the Visayas. And out of that 16 provinces, we have declared 11 out of 16. So, 5 na lang yung remaining provinces na hindi na nahi-handover na rin namin. Okay. But what I can tell you, as soon, before the end of year, next year, tapos na lahat ito. In fact, we will hand over to the local government sa Peace and Order Council ang Samar and Northern Samar. Yung 5 natitira, yun na lang yun. Samar, Northern Samar, Capiz, Iloilo, and Negros Occidental.
I think recently you handed over, I saw in your Facebook page, what...
Ayung Guimaras siguro.
Oh, yung Guimaras. Yes. That was the latest.
Actually, ito naman ay matagal lang na-declare. Mm-hmm. Kaya lang, dineclare ulit ito para magkaroon ng kasulatan talaga. Mm-hmm. Matagal na. Matagal nang maayos ang Guimaras. 2008 pa.
It was a signing with the provincial government.
Yes, provincially. Mm-hmm. Ang procedure kasi, siya sa kanila namin tina-turnover sa Peace and Order Council. Sila kasi ang sila ang chairman dyan. So, isumatotal, nasa PNP na, nasa local government na, kami ngayon ang support sa kanila.
And everyone's hoping that such peace and order in Guimaras, hopefully it will be maintained.
Oh yes, definitely yes. Napakatahimik ng Guimaras, napakaganda ng Guimaras.
And actually, sir, for the past 6 years, there was no record of any violent activities or violent incident in the island of Guimaras.
Okay, before we continue, let's take a break.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and of course, with me is Attorney Margaret Yu and Lieutenant General Nicanor M. Vivar, the 16th Commander of Central Command, and of course, Colonel Sam Gotico of the U3. Before we talk about the handover of Guimaras Island, so sir, ano pa ba sir yung mga kulang na limang provinces na kailangan nating i-clear?
Yung limang provinces actually ay Northern Samar, Samar, Capiz, Iloilo, at saka Negros Occidental. And fortunately, by December, Northern Samar and Samar will be declared as peaceful and ready for development provinces. So yun na lamang na lima na yon. And hopefully, start of the year 2015, tatlo na lamang yung ating i-cater. Yun nga, Capiz, Iloilo, and
ano yung pinakapalas po na
Negros Occidental.
Negros.
Yes.
Ano yung problem sa Negros? How come it will be the last province?
Nagkataon lamang na siya yung nasa huli, but kaya namin siyang matapos before the end, before June of 2015.
Mm-mm.
Or earlier. Maayos naman na rin din yung probinsya na yon. Except that yun nga, meron pang armed groups na kinikater namin. But as soon as possible, we can clear that portion of the province.
Earlier, we were talking about disaster preparedness. What are our partnerships with foreign groups with regard to this?
Asa ngayon, wala pa kaming talagang foreign na counterparts. Kasi wala pa naman, well, of course, wala pa.